right, guys, we're going to go ahead and get started with this session. And if I can get everybody's attention, we're going to go ahead and get started. One of the great things about this is that having some of the best in the network to be able to come and to share with all of us of what they're doing in their business. One of the great things about Heidi is Heidi, despite what the market is doing, and we hear everybody saying, oh, the market's down. Yes, in many cases, the market is down. And that's not, that is the case in her area as well. But Heidi's business is continuing to grow on top of everything that the headwinds she's had. So this is what's going to be great. If you haven't heard Heidi speak, Heidi comes to us from the Tri-City, or how would you say it, Raleigh? Or,
well, you're probably saying, thinking Triangle, but Triangle. Raleigh, North Carolina.
Raleigh, yeah. North Carolina area. She has been tremendous as far as an encouragement to me through the years. The ideas, she is the tip of the spear with some of the things that we're doing as a brand, some of the things that we've been implementing in our agents. And so I'm excited to introduce you to Heidi Harris.
Hey guys, how are you? Is everybody having fun?
Yeah.
We're learning so much. I love this conference. It's personally my favorite conference. I think that it's the one that I can come to, get so many ideas. My brain like freezes and then I panic and then I go home and I'm like, oh yeah, let's just make three, okay? So if you can do three things when you get home, y'all, if you can do this system I'm about to teach you, I promise you when you come here next year, you're gonna see me and give me a big old hug, and you're gonna be like, Heidi, thank you so much. This did not just transform my business, it also transformed my team members' business. Now, I know that not everybody in here has a team, and that's okay, because the way that this started was, it was a me problem. I'm very reactionary, as I'm sure most of us are. And you know, today I've got to do this, I've got to do that. And I was like bouncing around and figuring everything out. And then I was like having these peaks and valleys where like last year I slayed it on social media. 35% of our closed volume came off of social media leads, and those are strangers, okay? So that was really good. But that's where I was putting my energy. And then I was like, well, I really need to do better with face-to-face because I really pulled back from that. And I was like, okay, so then I talked to Jimmy, I don't buy leads, I buy lunch. So then I started getting in front of people and having lunches with people because I'm not gonna be the person that does Zillow Flex. That's just not my business. I like the face-to-face where people already know me, like me, trust me, wanna hire me. So I came up with an accountability system, me and my real estate coach, and it has been absolutely amazing what it's done, not just for me and my business, my marriage, parenting, being a good friend. I've noticed what it does is it calms this static, this chaos that we have at all times of like, oh my gosh, I have to do this, I have to do that. And you can just shrink it down. And then you have the energy and the time to focus on other things. So it's been absolutely wonderful for me, and I hope that it's the same for you. I do want to start out with a quick story, though. Vince called me and invited me to do this speech. I was in New York on my way to Greece, and he was like, Heidi, will you speak on accountability? I know that's what you've been really crushing this year. And I was like, yeah, and I was so excited because I was like, now I've got 7 hours on an airplane where I don't have to bother my husband. I can just do this speech. So for 7 hours, I had the speech done in June. This is my seventh time redoing it, so I hope you guys like it. But I was like, God, I don't have a great opener for this speech. What should I do? And I was kind of panicking about it. And then I got to the airport in Raleigh, and God was like, hold your beer. This is going to come through right now. So I get to the airport, and I'm checking in. You know, like if you have to check your bag, you have to go to the kiosk to get that sticker thing. I'm checking in and the people in front of me are having a really hard time. Everybody's taking forever. By the time I finally get a chance to check in, I've missed my flight. And United does it in a very gentle way. Bright red letters. You have missed your 45-minute deadline to get on your flight. And I was like, oh my gosh, right? Like I've got sweat in all the inappropriate places. I didn't know what to do. So then it says, go to the special assistance counter. And I figured, well, I need special assistance. So I went up there. And as I'm waiting for my next flight to get rebooked, that flight I miss because it's taking them so long. And I'm like, okay, so I've missed two flights in the span of 10 minutes. And I was here on time. I was trying to like focus my energy and not be an asshole. And I see a manager. And so I say, hey, you know, is there any way you can help me? This just happened. Is there any way you can push it through? Because we're in an industry that like it can't hurt to ask. Like, we can try for some miracles, right? And I ask her, and she goes up to the lady at the desk. Pretend that your knee is the desk. And she goes, switch her to a new flight, and walks away. And me being the client, me being the customer, I felt this big. And at that moment, I was like, okay, accountability. The lady at the desk that's trying to help me doesn't really care. And she doesn't care because her boss doesn't care. And whether I get on that flight or not, they've made their money. They're in a sales world, not a service world. And I'm in TSA pre-check, and I'm like, oh yeah, I'm in a service world, right? Like, I'm gonna let all these guys know this. But then the thing that I started thinking about is my team cares so much. They give a damn so much, because guess who else gives a damn, right? And that is contagious. And the cool thing that I've learned about accountability is it's not sexy. It kind of sounds like, oh, I don't want to be accountable. Like, this does not sound good. I don't want to do this. But once you do it, it's fucking fire. Am I allowed to cuss in here? It's too late. Here we go. Am I doing this? Where's that guy? There we go. Okay. So the thing about accountability, remember I said it's not just about what you're doing in your business. It's other things. Now, if you read this up here, that's a big oof moment. Nobody is reading that up there and saying, I am dominating it when it comes to my family. I am dominating the diet game. I'm killing it with real estate, right? There's somewhere that we're falling short. And Lindley, I hate to call you out here, but I'm going to anyway. We had a great conversation at convention about tracking macros. And if you don't know about tracking macros, it's like the amount of carbs, fat, and protein that each body uniquely needs. And if you do that right amount, you will lose weight. And I was telling you, you know, this is something that I'm doing, I'm really pursuing, and you're like, yeah, girl, same, me here, or me too. And so that's really what kicked off this whole thing for accountability, because I was like, if what I'm eating can change my body, how come what I'm doing is not changing my business? So here's us real estate agents. If anybody needs accountability in the world, it's us. Because we got into this job because we don't want a boss. But now we don't have a boss that tells us what to do. So we're just kind of wandering around, hoping we get some sales, this work, that work, go to this networking thing, you know, learn these ideas at Explosion. But there's so many other things. The lawsuits, like, accountability truly trickles into everything. My favorite three things here, though, are the bottom three. This has given me such a gift with work-life balance, because I know once I get my chart done, and I promise you the chart's coming, but once I get the chart done, if my kid's sick at school or like the crazy stuff that just happens to all of us every day, I can rest easy knowing I'm not letting myself down. We are constantly serving people. We are constantly helping and impacting people. What about us? And so this will also give you that wholeness in your heart that you're not just out there figuring it out. Balance and pillars. The next slide is talking about pillars. And pillars, something that you talked about earlier when you said pick your five. What are the five things that you do in your business that work for you? If one's not working, how do you switch to the next one? Okay, so this has also given me a balance in my pillars. What I mean by that is, remember I said last year I had a great social media year, not such a great face-to-face year. This year, it's balancing because I've done this. And because it's balancing, I'm not letting any of those pillars down, so my business is growing. Insanity. Y'all, we're just crazy people that are all in here like, hoorah, real estate! But this, the thing about accountability is that once you've got it figured out, you've got your system, and your system might be a little bit different than mine, and that's okay. But these are the different pillars. Now, if you are a team leader, I think that's something that's really, really wise for you to consider, is it's not just the pillar for you, it's also the pillar for your team members. So, for example, I have a guy on my team, his name's Mike. He's a magical guy. He's like one of my favorite people in the whole world. He would never come here. Like, the idea of coming here and networking, like, he's just like, no thanks. He loves an open house. He loves buying leads. Like, he's just got different things, and that's okay. We're all different. So, and these slides will be going out to you guys if you don't want to write them all down. But these are really important to know what your pillars are. as Jimmy said, pick five. Pick five that are your favorite and you're really good at. And if one's not working, change it. And then when it comes to accountability, we can edit all of this together. So, like I said, I was very reactionary, which made my team very reactionary. And the thing about my team is we have a lot of fun. We are really good friends. But when you walk into the office and nobody's selling anything, that's what we're there for, right? So I have, when you walk into my office, if you've seen my social media, there's a bright pink wall on this side. On this side, there's a gecko board. If you guys haven't seen what gecko boards are, a lot of people have them up here in their offices. And it has what our team's goal is for the year, and what every team member's goal is for the year, and where they are currently tracking on it. Now, when I first put this in, I thought, my team's gonna walk in and they're gonna feel like they're this big. Because if they're not selling, they're gonna feel so small. And then what I realized was, that's a leader problem. That's my problem if that's how they're feeling. I want them to walk in and be like, Renee, you got that under contract? Tell me about it, right? And so I had to lead that way. I had to change everything that I had from I to we. There were a lot of things that I had to change so that they could change and be excited about the change. Because just like the name of this, accountability is, nobody really wants it, but you can absolutely flourish if you have it, right? So I wanted the team to feel that without me like slamming it down their throats. So we created an accountability culture. Now, who moved my cheese? I mean, if you haven't read it yet, this year is the year of who moved my cheese, right? Like, we're all like, wait, what? We're down how much? Okay. So that's a great one for this year. Atomic Habits, legendary. What I do with my sales meetings, we have them every Tuesday, as most people do, is we've created a bit of a book club. Now, I don't read. I listen wonderfully, but I don't love to read. So we all just do audiobooks. And for me, on my team, I'll buy them the audiobook and I'll send it to them, or I'll give them the printed thing. And I give them like 2 weeks, a week, whatever it is, depending on how big the book is. And we go back in and we dive into these things. By inviting my team to be ingesting the same thing that I'm ingesting, we all get on the same wavelength. And there's a huge power in knowing that the people that you're surrounded with, the people that you're entrusting your business with, are all thinking the same things, mostly, as you are. Now, this book right here, I just found it. If y'all have heard about it before, Exactly What to Say for Real Estate Agents. It is incredible, and if you do it, or if you get it, I would suggest getting the audiobook, because Phil M. Jones, who's the author, has a beautiful English accent, but you can hear exactly how he's delivering things. I think that if I read it, I'd be like, ooh, that might be a little harsh. But the way he delivers exactly how to say things is absolutely magical. And it's so fun as a team leader to hear people in my office saying these things that he's saying. And I'm like, we're doing it. This is so cool. And fun fact, if you follow me on social, if you look at my videos and you read this book, all my openers for videos are the same openers as what Phil M. Jones says to use as conversation starters, which has also helped my social media go up because people are now listening longer. So it's really amazing book. The other thing that we implemented was our team text chain was always like, hey, who has a good inspector for a pool or whatever? Now every time somebody's going under contract, we're posting about it in the team chat. I want everybody to know what everybody's going through. If we have a hard client, if we have a crazy negotiation, we are now over communicating. And what it's done is if you're seeing all these other people have all these other success stories and you don't have anything, you're gonna wanna grind out and get some things under contract so you can participate. But the interesting thing here is I have, after 4 days of negotiating, we finally got 700 Maple Brook under contract. We. This is a team, okay? So I made sure I had to switch that in my mind of how we're doing that. Now, Gecko Board is exactly what I was telling you guys about. It's fantastic. I think it's like $40 a month, if anybody here has it. $40 a month, okay. So basically what we do is we have a Google Doc. I can send it to you if you want. And basically you're putting in what you have under contract, what your goals are, everything. And it calculates it beautifully, and you can edit this to look however you want, so it comes up on a screen in your office. So like I told you, when you walk into my office, we have our goals and what everybody's currently doing. In my office, there's a separate TV, and it has who's under contract, who the co-op agent is, closing date, whatever. Because as the team leader, if somebody calls me and asks a question, I can just like look up and know exactly what it is. So anyway, I've had Gecko Board since I came to Explosion 4 years ago, never saw it, went home, it was the first thing I did. Now we're changing everything to Looker Studio. Looker Studio is free. It's done by Google. Personally, I think it's better looking. The issue with Looker Studio compared to Gecko Board is that with Gecko Board, and I don't understand how computers work, but like the software automatically updates it. For Looker Studio, I have to have an old laptop like opened so that it can go from that laptop to Looker Studio. It sounds like you understand what I'm saying. Does that make sense? Okay, cool. So if you have an old computer, Looker Studio is free and easy. If not, do Gecko Board for $40 a month. Anyway, but when you're talking to your team, when you're talking to your friends, I want you to be including them in your life and in your business. The other thing is, this is a gong, and if you're a 12th grade boy like I am, we call it the closing gong, and sometimes it's the closing bong, but it's really a gong. And anytime that we have a closing, we have everybody in the team come up. Whose closing was it? They get to hit the gong. They talk about how they met the person, how the contract went, any wild things that happened during the contract, and then how closing went. That's really important, because we can be up here and it's like, yeah, okay, Andrew Undum closed 500 deals, whatever. How? How did you meet these people? Like, that's what I'm interested in. I want people to share with me. I want to be inspired by what they're doing. So the gong has been a lot of fun. Plus, my office is filled with old dudes, and when they hear the gong go off, they just all giggle at us, because like I'm the girl with like the hot pink office and everything. Every sales meeting that I have now has an agenda. The agenda I do normally the night before, it's just on Canva. If you want this, just email me and I can send you the template. But the agenda has kept us on task. I don't know about you guys, but it's so easy to be, oh, what'd you do last Friday, right? This keeps us on task, and it gives us a rhythm for each sales meeting. You'll see my favorite things are at the very bottom. It's, well, you can't really read it. But this says, this week I will, and last week I did. So this week I will do circle prospecting. Last week I did 4 open houses. And so it's telling everybody what your goals are. And I always write down what people say that they're going to be doing this week so that we can circle around to it next week. And it keeps us all on a level together of what our goals are. Now, every fourth Tuesday, the team gets together and we go to lunch. Now, we prospect. So we have a sales meeting. We all sit around. We prospect. And it's so much fun because we all get to compete against who's getting the most amount of appointments. And the competition, the fun, that has been awesome. And then we go have lunch and we're just friends. Like, we just enjoy it. But having a team where winning is fun changed everything for us this year. This is my accountability chart. I do this every day. So like I said, I have a real estate coach, and his favorite thing is when he has live access to this. This is on Google Drive. He enjoys going into it. He lives in Richmond. He enjoys going into it and seeing me update it, because it's normally like 9:30 at night where I'm like, okay, I did this, I did that, whatever. And he can see me live doing this. Having somebody else that can look at this and call you on your SHIT is pretty darn important. But as you'll see, this covers all of my pillars. So back in yesteryear, meaning last year, I was like, okay, focused on closings. I'm focused on closings. I'm focused on closings. No! You can't get to closings without appointments. So then it turned into appointment set. And you can set as many appointments as you want, but how many appointments were held? How many listings did you get signed? How many buyers did you get signed? Do you want more listings? Do you want more buyers? Well, that helps me figure out where I need to be setting my appointments so that my listings and buyers all then fall into suit. How many contracts did we get under contract? How many closings did we have? Right? So this is the meat and potatoes right here, right? But this is how we get there. How many texts did I send involving real estate? How many CMAs did I do? All right, so if you follow me on social, you know I'm doing this 2 CMAs a day nonsense. And it is a lot of work. But I have a template that I got from Andy, and he's doing the 2 CMAs a day too. And basically it's like, hey, I just wanted you to know how much your home's worth, like this is what's happening in the market, whatever, this is how much your home's worth. If you wanna know more or get a specific number, contact me, and I'd love to book a time to see you. If you have somebody that can like print and put it in the mail for you, it saves so much time. But like I'm like legitimately like going through and doing true CMAs for each person. And then on top of that, so then my clients are hearing from me with that. On top of that, I have HomeBot. If you guys haven't checked out HomeBot, they're right over there. They're one of our sponsors. I have HomeBot. I go in and I update my HomeBot so that then my numbers match their numbers. Normally they're not too far off. But also you get an email from HomeBot saying that I just updated it. Because my goal is that I'm everywhere. My goal is when you think real estate, you can't not think about me because I'm touching my people one way or another, right? So the 2 CMAs a day has been awesome. Phone calls, y'all, I struggle with phone calls. I don't know why. Maybe it's my generation, I don't know. It's just the idea of being like, hey, who do you know wants to buy or sell? Like, I would never say that. So I've got to like kind of think of a way. So like if somebody's kid's going off to college, like I'll call and try to get in there. I don't know, I'm so awkward with phone calls. It's not my thing. But my coach wants me to do at least 10 a week. So I do it blood, sweat, or tears. Open houses, I suck at an open house. It's not my thing also. But remember, my team's doing this too. So Mike, who crushes it at an open house, his open houses are a lot bigger than his text or DMs or whatever. Lunches, I am big on lunches. Normally I have 4 to 5 lunches a week. If you follow Jimmy's podcast, I am a big believer in sitting down with people, buying their lunch, getting to know what's going on in their lives, pouring on them, loving on them. The business that has come from it is ridiculous. So that has been good. It's just July was weird because a lot of people are traveling. Handwritten notes. I don't know about y'all, but I save all my handwritten notes. And my goal is if I see somebody, if I appreciate somebody, I'm gonna write them a handwritten note. And before, I would do that maybe like, what, once a month? But now, because I'm using this accountability chart, it's making me, it's forcing me to not put a zero in there. So I'm like, okay, well, I'll just go ahead and do it, right? Now, the difference between videos and social media posts here is videos are videos that I've previously recorded. Posts are actually posts on social media. So sometimes they're the same numbers because maybe I recorded 3 videos and then posted 3 on video, or sorry, on social. Sometimes they're different because maybe I'm saving it for another day, but that's the difference between those two. Mailers, if you're on my mailer list, sorry, but I'm big into mailers. I send something to everybody in my sphere of influence. I send people, my referral people, postcards, anything that will help me stick out, I absolutely do it. Networking, so again, July, 00001. But I'm gonna call, this is my one networking event of this week. I'm in front of people, I'm meeting people. Also, side note, I sold $6 million worth of real estate from last year's explosion. Talk to people, guys. The referrals in this room are absolutely ridiculous. So make sure that you don't hold back. Make sure that you're introducing yourself to people, okay? Also, if you have anybody moving to Raleigh, let me know. Okay, and then for sale by owners, I never did a FSBO, and so I called one, and now it closes next week. I was like, that actually worked. It was wild. Hot sheets, my friend Jeremy, that if you guys have met him, he's here this week. He had to teach me what a hot sheet was. I didn't know. I guess a lot of people do know. I didn't know what it was. So new to my sphere of influence, I try to get 5 people on my new to sphere of influence each week. That's always what I told people. And then when I did this chart, I was like, no, I don't. I've been lying to people. But now it's like, well, who else can I add to my sphere of influence, right? So it's a very conscious way to go through and make sure that you are good. Now, remember when I said earlier that this accountability chart really helps me because I can condense, so like if my daughter gets sick at school, I can go get her? I have this open all the time on my laptop. I'm constantly updating it. At night, I do it right before I go to bed. Because I'm like, I'm not like, ooh, I texted that person, let me do it. That's normally where I have to like go through and check my DMs and check my text to add it all up. But if I've done what I need to do right here, but like I'm finding that my husband feels a little disconnected from me, can I go to the grocery store and pick up his favorite thing so that when he gets home, I can make him his favorite meal? Yeah, because I'm balanced up here. My clients are good, my team is good. I'm more healthy now knowing that this is taken care of. Again, the static just reduces. So that's been really amazing for me with my family. The other thing about accountability is I think that there's this idea that the leader is the one making everybody accountable. But accountability is not just horizontal, it's also vertical. And what I mean by that is, yes, I'm gonna keep my team accountable because that's why they're with me. But also, I want them to keep each other accountable. I want them to check in on each other. Hey, I know that your numbers aren't exactly where you wanna be. Do you wanna go door knocking with me? Like, I want them to have this tribe where we all are in it together and we're all having fun and having success. And truly, the thing that has touched my heart the most this year is seeing the team connect and being like, hey, let's go do that together. You know, Heidi, what you wanna do, whatever. And the whole, this I knew would happen. This was such a surprise. And it's been so freaking awesome. I've loved it. A lot of folks are saying the economy is down. Of course it's down, like, of course. But if you're out in front of people, if you are making an impression, if you are meeting people, helping them, we have so much knowledge that we forget that we have. If you can get in front of people and help them, you can make your own economy. And I want you, if you take anything away from this, I want you to take that away. Because we are not victims. We are entrepreneurs. Name an industry that works harder than we do. And we are in control of how much we make. We can make as much as we want. It's all about how much we're working and how effective we are, right? So make your own economy. Don't be a victim. This QR code up here is my contact info. I welcome you to scan it. That will put it right in your phone so that you can save it. So if you ever have any questions for me about this, or if you ever have a referral, let me know. But the thing about accountability is that though it is not sexy, it is the only way to get to the next level. So this morning when you saw all those top producers out there and everybody's like, yeah, you know, top four in the network, amazing. But how did they get there? This. So if you want to do, if you want to get better, if you want to not be a victim, kick up your accountability. Okay? Does anybody have any questions?
What did the text look like? I mean, you had a lot of texts that went out.
Yeah.
What's an average text that you're sending out?
I do a little bit of everything. So, for example, I've got this buddy named Kyle, and he has a very specific taste. He wants a contemporary ranch-style home, which I don't know about your markets. We don't have many. So I will hop on the MLS and just search and be like, hey, I don't know if this is for you or not. That's a Phil M. Jones, what to say for real estate agents. I don't know if this is for you or not, but I wanted to send this to you. And then it'll be like, oh, I like this. I don't love that part of town. Is there anything up here? No, not right now, but I'll set you up on a portal, right? So like, it's just stuff like that. Another thing might be, I was driving through an area of Raleigh the other day. I saw a house that was for sale. It was for sale for $425. I had a buyer buy in that neighborhood for $225 2 years ago. Now, the $425 is overpriced, but I contacted the buyer and I was like, hey, did you know this is what's going on in your neighborhood? And she was like, holy cow. I was like, yeah, there's an open house this weekend. Just go by and check it out, right? So it's just stuff like that, just real estate, having fun. But if it's like, hey, Jimmy, hope you're having a great week, that's not a text. That does not qualify for this. This is like real estate specific direct texts.
DMs, what are those?
DMs are direct messages on Instagram.
What does it look like though?
Yeah.
Thank you for thinking.
I was like, is he serious? Okay, cool. Anyway, so, I mean, there's many people in this room that I'm sending DMs to all the time. So it's really just like, I see something funny, I send it to them, or like, I really like motivational things that I'll send to people, or like if I had a conversation with somebody and I knew that they were struggling with something and then I saw something, I'm like, thought of this, wanted to send it to you. So it's just touching base with people. It's just being social on social media. Bingo. Yep. Yep. These are weeks, yeah. Yeah, so she was asking, how do I keep track of this throughout the day? So if I'm in my office and doing a handwritten note, honestly, it feels good to be like, like update it. I don't have to, I'm gonna remember that at night. But normally at night, like 9:30, where I have my hair up and my retainer in, like a real sex beast, I like to go on here and just like update exactly what I'm doing. And I truly go through my cell phone and I'm like, okay, I sent that text, I sent that text. And some days I'm like, go ahead, girl. And some days I'm like, I gotta do better tomorrow, right? But it's, we're having the week to do it. And truly, I just do this Monday through Friday. I really try to take my weekends off. So it's really a Monday through Friday thing. So I'm gonna send it to Vince. Vince is then gonna send it to you guys. My issue that I'm working on behind the scenes is it's in Google. And so if I send it to you and you update it and then you update it, you're gonna, so I'm trying to figure out. Andy's gonna help me. Cool, awesome. You guys are awesome. Yes, ma'am. All right, so she's asking about my lunches and if I have a strategy with it. Heck yeah, I have a strategy. So if it's somebody that I've done business with before, I just haven't seen lately, and really just getting on social media and being like, I don't really know what's going on in that person's life. I'll just text and be like, hey girlfriend, you wanna get together, have some lunch? Cool, what about Thursday at noon, right? It's not real estate. It is real estate. But it's like, I just wanna connect with you and know what's going on with your family, whatever. Those have been so amazing. And what's wild is at the end of almost all these lunches, they're like, well, how can I help you? I'm like, well. So like we all work together. Did that help answer your question? I mean, it's super like easy just getting on somebody's schedule. Yeah.
I got the results of that.
He asked about the results of it. I think I started doing it. I'll get to you in just a second. I think I started doing it last October, Jimmy. By April, rough guess, I closed about 4 million in closed volume just from people that are like, hey, I didn't realize my friend was looking and I just saw you and whatever. So that's been great. Traditionally, it's 75% SOI, 25% didn't know them before, and didn't know them before truly social media. And it's just because when I moved to Raleigh, I didn't know anybody, so I was like, how can I get in front of people? And yes, it's great to like, if me and Rachel were having lunch, like, yeah, that would be awesome, but that's one person. So if I can spend 5 minutes doing a video that a few hundred or thousand see, like that's a lot more of an impact. So that's kind of my more comfortable place because I'm just trying to be on top of people's mind. But yeah, so it's traditional. Last year we had a bigger year on social, but I think this year will be about 25% again.
I might have missed this in the beginning, but how do you go over this with your team? They self-report one by one in front of everybody, so there's that accountability.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so he asked about the team and how the team keeps themselves accountable with this. So that's in the meeting agenda. So the first thing up here, it says agenda in pink, and then underneath it says scoreboard. This is the scoreboard is that accountability chart. And to be completely transparent with you guys, if you see my numbers and some of my team numbers, they're very different because we are very different. They don't wanna be a team leader. The idea of being here is not their thing, right? So I'm not hard on them. I understand that that's what they wanna do, but by having this, what they're seeing is they're seeing where they're strong and where they're weak, which gives us all a lot of confidence, and it helps me as a team leader also know, because my team also, they don't come into the office. I wish that they did. They don't. So it's like, are you working? Like, what are you doing when you're home? So it helps me also as a leader, and they cheer each other on, which is cool.
So they have to go through and rip their numbers out loud?
Yeah, I mean, I have it. So I'll be like, yeah, I just pull it up. And I just drop it on the Gecko Board TV. Yeah, Lindsay. It's an amazing question. Can you hear her? So she was asking what the difference is between working on my business and in my business, which are two very different things. And you're right, this is all just feed the beast. This is all just feeding the beast. This is not like negotiating repairs or like any of the stuff, the meat and potatoes, right? I do have a transaction coordinator. She takes a lot of that weight off against me. I know that this is not like really what we're doing here, but my goal is to get new clients. It's what I'm good at. So my goal when I wake up, I'm like, how do I get new clients today? So she's more in charge of like making sure that the clients are happy and good. Some realtors really have an issue with passing that off, as I did as well. For me, I treat it like a doctor's office. When I go into the doctor's office, I'm being greeted by the receptionist, the nurse is taking care of me, the doctor comes in and comes out. For all, I do everything that's macro, she does everything that's micro. So she's doing like the paperwork and stuff like that. So that really frees me up a lot, so that my goal is how do I get new clients? Because it's not just for me, it's also new clients for my team. Oof. We don't show listings. Well, I would love some higher luxury that needed me there. And then when that happens, Lindsay, you're the first person I'll tell. She was talking about how she has to go sell her or show her higher end listing. She does great in luxury. But I don't have that. So truly, like, it helps me focus more on this because I'm not so much in the car, you know, doing X, Y, or Z. But when I am in the car, and I put out a reel, like, last year where I was like, does my radio even work? Because when I'm in the car, like, I'm just on the phone the entire time. But if I'm in the car and, like, I know I've got to get some phone calls out, like, that's where I just crank them out. So that's something else that you can do by, like, because this is, it's such an eye-opener of, like, I made zero phone calls this week. And something else I've told my kids is mommy's job is not selling houses, mommy's job is setting appointments. So they're like, mommy, how many appointments did you set today? And there's nothing like disappointing an eight-year-old. He's like, oh, that's what you did today? Yeah, I'm sorry, Sawyer, it'll be fine. But anyway, so I haven't had that where I had to go show houses. Now, does anybody else have any other questions? Yes, Olivia. She's asking, when I get leads, how do I divvy it up for my team members and keep it fair? It's not fair. I did a round robin before, and it's not good, because then you're fitting a round peg into a square hole. So Mike on my team lives in Cary, which is south of Raleigh. Renee lives in North Raleigh. So truly, if they're not gonna be my clients, it's more like who specializes in that area, who knows, because Mike's really great with luxury, Renee's really great with first-time home buyers, so it really is figuring out their strengths and what goes where, but I don't do a round robin. How do I cut a team member? Well, let's have a tequila afterwards. And yeah. Yeah. She's saying, how do I decide what items are on the left column? I've changed this so many times. So in July, I added FSBO hot sheets and new to SOI. So I just keep on playing with it. And truly, depending on what your pillars are, yours is gonna be totally different. And me and Andy are somehow gonna figure out how to get you this document where you can edit it yourself and put in to according to your pillars. Yes. She's asking if I have a goal for each one. Yeah, so I do have a real estate coach, and he, when we get on our calls, this is the first thing that we pull up. And he normally says, you know, okay, so the week of 4th of July, I didn't do a lot of text because I was in New York City with my family. So the next week, he was like, I need you to do at least 65. And I was like, great, I'll do 75 because that's how God made me. So, like, what I do is I put 75 in here in red. Uh-huh. Well, sorry, I do 75 next to it, and then I update it each day here just to, like, keep my eye on the goal. That's just how I But also, like, now I know my rhythm. I know that I'm better with DMs and texts. And so I know I need to have higher numbers there than elsewhere. Okay? Cool. Yes, ma'am. No, because I want a whole conversation. Yeah. Yeah. She's saying like the text, it just like drags on and on and on. She's like, I've got to go do something else. Well, the glory about text is it's made so that you can get to it whenever you get to it, right? Audio, voice audio, where you just like, hey, I'm in between appointments, but I wanted to get back to you real quick, and you just send them an audio message. That will shorten a conversation rather than text all the time. I've got this weird thing in my head. I have a lot of weird things in my head. One of the weird things in my head is the more money you make, the more audio messages you send. I don't know why. So when I send an audio message, I'm like, that's a bad bitch. Go ahead, Heidi. So I love an audio message. Mm-hmm. Rather than just like, you're under contract, period. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. So you get to use some of your personality. Anything else, folks? Yeah. Yeah, so Michael's asking if my team can get anybody's accountability sheet. Yes. So what I cut off under here is the tabs where it has all of us under there so that we can just click on it. So that's why it makes it so easy in the meetings is it's just like, here's mine, here's Renee, here's Mike, right? When you just hammer through it. Now, I did bring some swag because I'm a nerd. So if anybody wants, I have some koozies for Vince's party tonight. I've got business cards with my QR code on the back. And I only brought 4 t-shirts because I thought that the check-in process at United was going to be a lot easier. And so if I knew it was going to be that hard, I would have brought more and made it more complicated. But I only have 4, and they're size medium. So if anybody wants them, grab them. It is it's the North Carolina state flag with love in it. So feel free to take it. It's soft. It's great. Guys, thank you so much. You are lovely. If you need me, holler. I appreciate you guys.